Psychological warfare, also known as psywar, is the use of psychological tactics and methods to influence the perceptions, emotions, attitudes, and behaviors of an enemy. The aim of psychological warfare is to weaken the opponent's will to fight and ultimately defeat them without even resorting to military force. The methods used in psychological warfare can range from propaganda and misinformation to scare tactics and psychological manipulation. Despite being perceived as a contemporary development, psychological warfare actually has roots dating back to ancient times, with evidence of its use appearing in various civilizations, such as the Greeks, Romans, and Persians. In ancient Greece, the art of rhetoric was used as a form of psychological warfare, with orators using their skills to sway public opinion and influence decision-making. The famous Greek philosopher Aristotle wrote extensively on the subject, outlining the techniques and strategies that could be used to manipulate public opinion. In ancient Rome, psychological warfare was often used in military campaigns, with the goal of undermining the enemy's will to fight. Julius Caesar famously used psychological tactics, such as spreading false rumors about his strength and military prowess, to intimidate his opponents and secure victories on the battlefield. In the Persian Empire, psychological warfare was used in diplomacy, with ambassadors and emissaries using rhetoric and other persuasive techniques to gain advantages in negotiations and international relations. Fast forward to the 20th century, psychological warfare methods became crucial in military and political strategies, with both world wars serving as major theaters for the use of these methods. The use of propaganda and psychological operations was widespread during both world wars, with both sides using various media to shape public opinion and undermine enemy morale. The rise of mass media, such as newspapers, radio, and later television, made it possible to reach a large audience with a single message and helped to further enhance the impact of psychological warfare. In the post-World War II era, psychological warfare continued to evolve, particularly during the Cold War. The US and the Soviet Union engaged in a battle for global influence and superiority, using various psychological methods, such as propaganda, disinformation, and psychological operations, to sway public opinion and undermine the adversary's political and military power. Psychological warfare methods are usually referred to as psychological operations, or PSYOPs, especially within the US military. Psychological operations specifically focus on the dissemination of information and ideas to influence the perceptions and attitudes of a target audience. As such, they can be overt or covert. Overt psychological operations are also known as white psychological operations. These involve the dissemination of truthful and transparent information. The goal of white PSYOPs is to build trust and credibility with the target audience, both domestically and internationally. This type of psychological operation is often used to communicate official government messages, such as updates on military operations or humanitarian aid information during conflict or disaster scenarios. White PSYOPs are distinguishable from other forms of psychological operations, as they do not involve any deceptive or misleading information and are intended to be open and transparent to the target audience. Covert psychological operations are often considered controversial due to their deceptive and untraceable nature. Gray PSYOPs use misinformation or partial truths to sow confusion and doubt, while black PSYOPs are used to discredit an adversary, using false propaganda or write out misinformation. Operation Mockingbird was a notable example of the use of psychological operations by the US government during the Cold War. Launched by the Central Intelligence Agency in the 1950s, Operation Mockingbird aimed to influence and control media content in the US and around the world to promote favorable views of the government and its policies. The operation involved the recruitment of journalists, editors, and media executives, who would then produce and disseminate information that was favorable to the government. Despite its controversial nature, Operation Mockingbird is considered one of the largest and most effective psychological operations in American history. In the 21st century, psychological warfare continues to be used in military and political contexts, with new technologies, such as social media and the internet, providing new tools for the dissemination of information and ideas. As global conflicts evolve and new technologies emerge, The role of psychological warfare is likely to remain a significant factor in shaping the outcome of future conflicts. What do you think? Let us know in the comments below if you would like to see more videos on psychological warfare. This is just the tip of the iceberg. Also, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.